it rather slowly. First, we'll analyze analysis of model test. The first 5 questions deal with what? Pillars. Almost all the questions are easy. You should get 5 out of 5. The second 5 questions deal with what? Para-jumble. The broad framework, 3 sentences you see the word villages, after that 2 sentences, after that 1 sentence. But 2 sentences, first 3 are easy, all the 3 sentences are related to villages, remote areas. And the next 2 sentences talk about in the past and after that what happened, contrasting view. And the last sentence is about recent times. So the passage or paragraph has been presented from the historical perspective, from the past to the present. If you grasp that, you should get the correct order, should not be a problem. After that, 5 questions related to errors, all the 5 are rather easy, should not be a problem. And passage also, I think you should get all the 10 correct, should not be a problem. Easy passage, interesting passage, useful passage, that is very important. Always remember, some passages, they are useful from a particular dimension, and some passages from a different dimension. Now this passage, some passages useful from all the dimensions. This passage related to environment, you may get a similar passage in prelims, a similar passage in mains, and they may ask you to write an essay in the descriptive paper. They may give a similar topic at the time of group discussion, and coming to interview may not be useful, but you should always look at the essay or the passage. How is this useful? And to what extent is it useful? That should be the top. When you think of the passage or the essay, you have to ask this question. Accordingly, you have to gather information about the passage. Here, how many words do you see? How many words passage is it? About 800 words? I think so, not more than 800 words. And about 800 word passage, then it is not enough related to environment. You have to gather more information, learn more words or lexical terms, learn more word combinations, then you are going in the right direction. Hope you guys are listening. Otherwise, it's a sheer waste of time. Today, this is March. March, April, May, June. After 4 months, you look at the papers casually, the scores will not improve. Very simple. There will not be substantial improvement. Today, single digit. After 4 months, also single digit. No use. But if you look beyond, you take a different perspective, you question, you analyze, you learn more from each question, from each passage, definitely you will see substantial improvement. And 4 months down the line, your scores will touch 15, 16, perhaps 18 also. And you may cross sometimes 20. Approach is very important. And one more suggestion I would like to give, all these passages based on SLEEP's concept. What do the letters stand for? Science and technology, legal, education, economy, polity, and socio-cultural problems. From today, whichever essay you get in the passage, the mock test paper, based on the passage, file them. Today's passage goes with what? Environment, socio-cultural problems. Maintain a separate file. Economy related, a separate file. Whenever you are free, try to learn more from these papers, more words, more combinations, and that aggressive learning will help you in the long run. There's a brief introduction. So, passage, you should get 10, all the 10 correct. And the last 5, close test, again, very easy, should not be a problem. But being practical, because you take the test under tremendous pressure, I feel good score is between 20 and 25. If you get 25 plus a paper like this, you're ready for the exam at the national level. You can tell yourself, you're ready for the exam. Now shall we start the first 5 questions? What do they deal with? The first 5 questions deal with pillars. My grandfather, his wealth among his 5 children. You're ready with the answer. Which option is that? Third option, divided. Now there are 2 ways of looking at this particular sentence. One, please make a note. What is the answer? The third option, divided. A lot of candidates across the country, they look at this question from that perspective. What is the question? Filler, my grandfather divided his wealth among his 5 children. Then they move on to the next question. But that will not help you in the long run. That is a wrong approach. Now please underline, I cannot write here, please underline the word wealth first. Then you underline the word among. Now we'll start with the preposition among. When you see the word among in the sentence, you have to recollect one is among and what is the other one? Amongst. So what is the difference between these two? You have to recollect. If the word after the preposition begins with a vowel letter or a vowel sound, we use what? Amongst. And also this word is a literary word. It goes with written English and effective English. Besides these two, you should also recollect two more words. Please write. I'm giving for the first time these two words. In one of the batches, a student asked me, sir, what is the difference between amid, amidst? Both mean the same. Then the question comes, you should ask the question, sir, what is the difference between among and amid? Are you guys listening? Among, please make a note. Among means surrounded by, and brackets you write, it goes with countable nouns. It goes with countable nouns. He is among his friends. Friends countable or uncountable? Countable. Now you write the word amid. Amid means in the middle. In the middle. And it goes with uncountable nouns. It goes with uncountable nouns. Amid rain. Rain is uncountable. In the middle of rain. Surrounded by, in the middle. Countable noun, uncountable noun. Now, I told you to underline one more word. Which one is that? Wealth, which part of speech is it? Noun, please write. Then you write the form, wealthy. Write the combination, wealthy person. Also write the combination, wealthy nation or rich nation. You all know the meaning of the word wealth. Wealth means what? Rich, being rich. So wealthy nation, wealthy person, which part of speech is it? Write adjective. I want you to respond. See, this is a new batch. I see a lot of fresh faces. And last year, that batch is not here, except a few students. And from day one, we start certain activities, that means your active participation, throughout you can enjoy. When I ask a question, you don't respond, then it is not a good thing. Are you guys listening? Huh. So when I ask a question, you have to respond. When I said wealthy person, wealthy country, what is the part of speech of the word wealthy? I expect that from you. It shows that you are attentive. It also shows that you know the part of speech, which is a good thing. Now, based on this, always remember, English is the richest language. You should not stop with one word or one concept. You should always explore related words, related forms, related combinations. Then you're going in the right direction. So here, a rich person or wealthy person or rich country or wealthy country, based on the word wealthy, please write, imagine some people are very rich. Some people are what? Very rich. There are two expressions, please write. We say, stinking rich. Then we also say, please write the word, filthy rich. Stinking rich, filthy rich. What is the meaning? Extremely rich. But surprisingly, English is a funny language. Underline the word stink, only stink. What is the meaning? Bad smell. Underline the word filth, only the letters, filth. Dirt. Filth means what? Dirt. Dirt. This is bad smell. And filth means what? Dirt. But here, stinking rich is a positive word. And filthy rich is also a positive word. Now when it comes to, have you copied? And one more thing I would like to request all of you, please be attentive. Please be alert. The moment I write, you should also write. And slowly I will stop writing. I want you to develop the ability to listen and write. Do you understand what I say? listen and write. I can give more information and you go to the higher level. Every time you look at the screen and write, you are at the primary level. But listen and write, you are at the higher level. That means what you are good at, taking running notes. You know the expression running notes. You should have that. Now please write the word. Extravagant. Also write the word lavish. Now rich people, they have a lot of money. They spend money just like that. They don't even think whether it is worth or not. Then what do we say? Extravagantly. Adverb, extravagant. Lavish, lavishly. Again, some people, they spend a lot of money without questioning. Regular, these two go with more with a specific occasion, but write the word spendthrift. Spendthrift. Lavish, extravagant, spendthrift. All are negative words. Spending money without thinking. Without thinking. Then when you think of these words, you should think of opposite, antonyms. Please write two words. First you write the word thrifty. Thrifty is a positive word. Also write the word frugal. Some people think and spend. Is it worth? They ask the question. If it is worth, they spend. Then what are the words? He is a thrifty person. What part of speech is thrifty? Adjective. He is a frugal person. Adjective. Positive words. And some people have a lot of money. They don't spend at all. So what is the word for that? So take two words. First you write the word miser. That is old English. Then you write the word stingy. Nowadays we use the word stingy. Now have you noticed from one sentence how many words have you got? About 7 or 8 or more than 8. This is what I call holistic approach and the right approach. You got some grammar related rules you could recollect and you have learned a few words. You should think that way every sentence. Shall I move on to the second sentence? People who put on weight, please underline put on. Below you write phrasal verb. Put on is what? Phrasal verb. What is a phrasal verb? A verb and a preposition. As a unit, it has a specific meaning, sometimes more than one meaning. Just hold that one. People who put on weight have to be careful of what they eat. So what is the answer from your side? The fifth option, please, must. Must have to be. That's a bit difficult. Of all the 5 questions, I consider this one rather difficult. Now when you come across any helping verb, what is the helping verb here? Please underline the word must. Then also underline the helping verb have. You should always recollect the uses or functions of that particular helping verb. Now what is the use of the helping verb must? You must attend the meeting. Means what? It means must. So write the first meaning. It means compulsory. It means compulsory. Please write the sentence. That's always better. You must attend the meeting. You must attend the meeting. It is compulsory. Write the second meaning. Second meaning must means it expresses personal obligation. What does it express? Personal obligation. Obligation imposed by the speaker, whoever is speaking. Imagine you are busy talking to your friends. All of a sudden you think of some important work at home. Your dad told you or your mom told you. Then what do you tell your friends? I must go. Here must mean what? Personal obligation you have imposed. Underline personal obligation. Obligation means what? Either it is your duty or you have promised to do it. Please write the meaning of obligation. Obligation means duty. Either it is your duty or you have promised to do it. But here, this is a nice question. Please write in your notebook, must have. This is one expression, must have. The meaning of that, please write the meaning. Must have means desirable. Something that is desirable. It is a must have. Means what? It is desirable. You want that one. They must have to be. It is desirable to be. To be what? Careful of what they eat. Do you understand the meaning? People who put on weight must have to be careful. What does it mean? They have to be careful, must have to be. Desirable, to be careful. They have to be careful, in a nutshell. They have to be careful. Hope you got the meaning. How many of you have chosen the fifth option, must? That's pretty good. Now go to, please write in your notebook, the phrasal verb, put on. Now, what is the context in the given sentence, put on weight? In this context, put on means what? Please write, add. Put on means what? Add weight. But put on has many meanings. Write one more meaning. Put on also means, typical meaning, write the meaning, wear. Wear your shoes, wear your clothes, wear your accessories. Then what do you say? Write the expression, put on your shoes. Put on your shoes means what? Wear your shoes. One more meaning of put on, to perform. To perform. Write one example. They are putting on a show. They are putting on a show. They are performing a show. Put on, perform. And we also use put on as a noun. Please remember, phrasal verbs are used as verbs, also as nouns. That awareness is also important. Please write one expression. She speaks with, he or she, that is your choice. Otherwise you will think I have gender bias. She speaks with a put-on accent. Put-on accent. Here it is an adjective. Put on accent. Accent is a noun. Put on accent means artificial, not natural. Artificial. Not real, not genuine. Put on accent. One more meaning, put on means to cheat or to deceive. Please write. To cheat or to deceive. Do you find this approach useful? Each question I'm giving more information. Now underline the word hardly. Among the options, what is the second option here? Then write two words, hard, hardly. Hard, which part of speech is it? Immediate answer. It is both. Please write adjective, adverb. He is a hard worker. There it is an adjective. He works hard. Here it is an adverb. What is the word hardly? Only one. Please write adverb. But it has a negative meaning. Please write hardly means what? Negative meaning. Not at all. And write one sentence. He hardly works. He hardly works. He hardly works means what? He doesn't work at all. A negative connotation. Shall I move on to the next question? Indian families, please underline the word families. They love only through food. So what is the word? Who says the fifth option? That's right. You should always consider the subject. What is the subject here? Please underline the word families. You should remember, you have to use your grammar knowledge. Noun, plural form. Can you use shows? So you have to reject immediately. Impose. Write the meaning of the word impose. Impose means force. That's an important word. Write one example. Don't impose your ideas on others. Don't impose your ideas on others. Generally, we say that way. We use that way. Don't impose your ideas on others. Don't impose your culture. Don't impose your traditions on others. Means what? Force. Other words are rather easy, but you have underlined the word families. What can you recollect? Are you guys listening? When you come across the word family or families, exam point of view, there is one important rule. They have given in many exams, it goes with common errors. So what should you recollect? What are you supposed to think of? Huh, very good. That girl has said, please write the expression family members. This has to pop up. Family members, right or wrong? Mark it wrong. What is the correct expression? Members of family. Please write members of family. Please put a star mark, family members. I read the Hindu every day. I think last week I was going through some articles, the front page, they use the expression family members. Family members of some girl, Warangal, some incident. Some girl was burnt alive. That article, the family members said something. The Hindu paper, the first page, expression family members. Now imagine a student reads that expression. What will he or she think? Which one is right, family members or members of family? In the exam you see family members, you tell yourself, the Hindu paper, I have seen family members, perhaps it is right. Then you lose, how many marks do you lose? Wrong answer? 0.25. Please remember, whatever you see in the Hindu paper, it doesn't go with the exam. We don't consider. Whatever you come across in conversational English, we don't consider. Imagine there's a knock. I say, who is that? Now the typical response, it's me. Conversational English, modern English. Again we say, who did you come with? Not correct. Whom did you come with? Again it's me, not correct, it is I. So don't consider whatever you see in the magazines or the Hindu paper. That goes with current English or modern English, we don't consider. Don't consider conversational English expressions. Not valid from the exam point of view. Never ever consider American English spellings or expressions. Not valid. Is that clear? So family members, right or wrong? Why no response? It is wrong, obviously. Don't consider the Hindu paper. Members of family is correct. Though the Hindu paper uses the expression family members, tell yourself, it is current English. What is it called? Current means what? Modern. Current or modern English. We don't consider. We consider only standard English. Shall I move on to the next question? What is the question number 4? The principal was kind enough to me leave. So what is the answer here? The second option, grant me leave. Now underline the word principal. Now you write two words in your notebook. First is, then you write the word. Generally we use in the plural form. Principal, head of the school. Principal. Principal means what? Value. But generally we use in the plural form. Principals. He is a man of principles. Please write one expression. Man of principles. Man of principles means what? Man of values. Also write one word. Man of integrity. That's an important word. He is a man of integrity. Means man of values, man of principles. Hope you are writing immediately. Now, any other word to be allow, grant, permit, assign. Assign means what? Write one word. Assign means allot. But write a better word. Please write this word. Delegate. Tomorrow you take up the job, you should be good at delegating your work. It's an important skill. Delegate. Delegate means what? Imagine you are the manager and you can do about 10 works. That is your capacity as an individual. But because of your designation, you have to do 20 works, part of your job responsibility. Then remaining 10, what will you do? You cannot do. You have to delegate. Successful managers are those who know how to delegate the work. If you are not good at delegating the work, then you go upside down how to manage 20 works and you become inefficient. You get frustrated. So delegation skill is an important skill at the workplace. Hope you got the meaning. Shall I move on to the next one? Question number 5. With fewer, please underline that word, in the market, banks have reduced team sizes in order to operations. In order to work operations, now here you have to see the combinations. These questions, double fillers, you can answer only based on exposure to the language, usage. We'll take each option and see. With fewer deals in the market, possible, dramatically right. Banks have reduced team sizes in order to work operations. In order to work operations, does it sound right? Mark it wrong based on the, underline the second word and mark it wrong. With fewer problems in the market, banks have reduced team sizes. This is not acceptable. More problems, the team sizes get reduced. No problems, the team sizes, it's quite the opposite. So practically it is not correct, mark it wrong. With fewer projects in the market, banks have reduced team sizes in order to face operations. Does it sound right? Face operations? No. Usage point of view, it is not correct. Mark it wrong. With fewer block, can you use the word block? Is it singular or plural? You cannot use a singular here. Reject the fourth option based on the word block. Hope you guys are listening. What is the fifth option? With fewer clients in the market, banks have reduced team sizes in order to sustain operations. That's a very good word. Answer is the fifth option. But write, sustain has got two different meanings. One meaning in this context, please write the meaning. Sustain means continue. Sustain means what? Continue. But one more word, we don't use sustain. Please write the word. Sustainability or sustainable practices. Sustainable practices mean what? Using resources wisely. Using resources wisely. Today the whole world is talking about sustainability. That means what? You have to use your resources wisely, keeping the future generations in mind. Then it is called sustainability. That's an important word. Please remember sustainability and also remember sustainable practices. Who has got all the 5 correct? That's very good. I appreciate. Now we'll see the para jumble. A bit difficult to project, but still. I will ask the question, you try to answer because a lot of new students. We will take the elimination approach. Can A be the first sentence? Say yes or no. Why? Underline the word these villages. Now when you read all the sentences, you understand the writer has taken a historical approach. Underline the expression in recent years. Can you start the sentence with this expression? When the approach is historical approach. Please mark it. It cannot be the first sentence. Many of them, can C be the first sentence? Why? Underline the word them. Can you start, can the first sentence be with a contrasting word? Underline the word however, mark it wrong. Hundreds of millions of Indians call rural and remote India home. This seems right, hold this one. Big and small Indian foreign companies have tried to set up shop in the past. In the past, again historical perspective, this cannot be the first sentence. Now, what is the first sentence here? It should be independent. Please make a note. E is the first sentence. Now, what is the clue for you? It talks about, please underline the word, remote India, rural and remote. What do you find in rural India? Are you, please respond. Rural India, what do you find? Cities, towns, villages. Villages, that is a clue. Now, based on that, what is the second sentence? C is the second sentence. What is C? Many of them, underline the word them. Them means millions of Indians. The first sentence he talks about millions of Indians. Many of them live and work in tiny, obscure, underline the word obscure, off the map villages. Now, for the next sentence, what is the clue word for you? Underline the word villages. What is the meaning of the word obscure? Not clear. Write the word. Obscure means not clear. Also write vague. Vague, not clear. Have you written? Fine. So what is the second sentence? C is the second sentence. What is the first sentence? I mean third sentence. A is the third sentence. For many years, these villages, see villages in the second sentence, repeated the same word. These villages have been a somewhat untapped market for consumer goods and services companies. This is the third sentence. So three sentences related to what? People who live in villages. One sentence, opening sentence, and two sentences related to villages. One, two, three you got. Then what is the fourth sentence? F is the fourth sentence. Please make a note. Big and small Indian and foreign companies have tried to set up shop in the past. Please underline the phrase in the past, but none have had lasting success. Now what is the fifth sentence? D is the fifth sentence. Contrasting view. However, few have been able to establish direct contact with villages of 5,000 people or less. So two sentences again related. In the past, but however, contrasting view. And what is the last sentence? What are you left with? Yes? Recent years. In the past, present, recent years. In recent years, the big consumer goods companies that produce everything from toothpaste to crisps have established a presence in small and mid-sized towns and districts. Who has got all the six correct? This is shocking. You know how many got correct? Five students. Only five students have got it right. What went wrong? How many of you have got the first sentence right? Raise your hands. That's pretty good. Two and three related to villages. How many? That's also good enough, but number has come down. After that, it is rather easy. Past, contrasting information, and present is what? Recent years. One of the reasons, because today is the first day, nothing to worry, don't get disappointed. But do remember, para jumble nowadays is not that easy. And how many marks para jumble? Answer my question, how can you become good at para jumbles? What do you think? You have to read a lot. Read what? You have to read the Hindu paper, but more than that, for para jumbles, you have to read magazines, international magazines like Economist, and you have to read science magazines like New Scientist, Scientific American, Discovery, Popular Science, and you have to read magazines like the Harvard Business Review and Psychology Today, Management Today. Then some students may think, what is he talking about? Is he in his senses? Where do we get all these and why the hell should we read? Please remember, today English for bank exams not based on grammar rules. I reiterate. Reiterate means what? Force, to say with force. To repeat, reiterate. Today the bank English for banks based on your exposure to the language. How do you get exposed to the language? Yes, there are two sources. One is listen a lot to the language, target language. Second, read a lot. Now, do you come across English outside? What is the language used? Obviously, Telugu. And that means what? One source is gone. Only one source you have. Which one is that? When you have no choice, then there is one idiomatic expression. Please make a note. What is it called? Hobson's choice. They have given in SBI more than 5 times this one. Hobson's choice means what? No choice. You have no choice. You don't read, you are not ready for the exam. A lot of students look at me with strange expressions when I say this. But I'm really sorry. I would like to reiterate, emphasize, stress. I would like to use all these words. If you are really, how many of you are serious about getting selected? Raise your hands. I'm sure all of you will raise your hands. Do remember, if you are really serious, really, see, motivation, interest, two types. One is, if I ask you, are you really interested? What will you say? Yes, sir, we are really interested. What are you talking? But generally what happens, two types of interest. One is superficial. Someone gets selected for IAS, someone starts preparing for IAS. We also feel like from tomorrow we'll start our IAS preparation. Or someone has got selected bank probation officer, we also get tempted. That is superficial. Don't think I'm trying to degrade or look down. Generally I'm speaking. A lot of people have superficial interest. Only a few have the other one. Please write this expression. They have the burning desire. That is real interest. Burning desire. Whether you're eating, standing, sleeping, doing something, it keeps on bothering you. It eats you all the time. I have to get selected, I have to get selected. Then we say you have the real interest. That is called what? Burning desire. How many of you have the burning desire? Fine, let us move on. And do remember, parajumbles not easy if you don't read. And imagine what will happen. Some students say, sir, we find the paper very boring, the Hindu paper. We don't feel like reading. We don't like. Who cares your likes and dislikes? Nobody cares. Important you have to read. Not important you don't have to read. There ends the matter. Do you understand what I say? Sir, I don't like static GK. Then be prepared for the consequences. Be prepared to listen to the music. Very simple. Whether you like static GK or not, who cares? From the exam point of view, it is important you have to learn. There ends the matter. Shall I move on to the next set of questions? It's very surprising. I expected most students to get the parajumble right. But doesn't matter. All things are difficult before they are easy. Initially everything is difficult. Slowly it becomes easy. You should always be optimistic. Now what are these questions? A lot of students love to spend time on these questions. Their favorite section. What is it? Spot the errors. Because a lot of students are obsessed with grammar. Grammar is everything. English means grammar. Grammar means English. That is not correct. English means comprehension. English means vocabulary. Now I speak English. How can you judge my English is good or bad? If I can speak fluent English, I can speak on any topic, anytime, anywhere. I use effective words. I use a lot of phrasal verbs. I use a lot of idioms. Then you consider my English outstanding. Imagine I have been teaching for the last 25 years. I know English grammar inside out. Will you consider I cannot speak? Will you consider, do you think I'm good at English? Not at all. So what matters, your proficiency matters. To what extent you're good at the language. Grammar is only one dimension. Don't get obsessed with one dimension. Take a holistic approach. Touch every dimension. Then you go in the right direction. Now shall I read out question number 11? Yes, sir. He took a sharp knife and torn the covering made of cardboard but could not open the packet. Now where is the error? Second part, what is it? Now generally what happens, here do you find the time phrase? Please put a star mark this question. In the exam, if you come across, spot the errors, any sentence with, any sentence with a time phrase, easy to answer. Based on the time phrase, you can decide the tense. Within no time, you can spot the error. But if you come across questions where you don't see the time phrase, every student cannot answer, cannot spot the error. You have to go to the higher level. What is that higher level? You have to look at the verbs. Tell me the verbs in this sentence. Please underline the word took. Then you underline the word torn. Then you underline the word made, the covering made of. But that is not a verb in the real sense, non-finite verb. But underline the word could not open the packet, could not. Now when you see a lot of verbs in either present or past or future, you have to tell yourself the whole context goes into past. How many verbs are in past? Two or three. Then you have to tell yourself the whole context goes into the past. Then every verb has to be in past. Now the word torn. What is the actual verb? Yes? Tear. What is the past form? Tore. What is the past participle? Torn. But here we have to use the past form or past participle form. Then what is the error and what is the correct expression? He took a sharp knife and tore the covering made of cardboard. How many of you have got this one right? Well, that is appreciable. But do make a note, please write next to the question, related to past tense, verb form. Past tense, verb form. Always, I insist, you have to write next to the question what it is about. In the long run, that helps you. So don't take things for granted. Shall I move on to the next one? Question number 12. Some people have generously contributed to the welfare fund, but they wanted that their names should not be published. This is an easy question, but under pressure, sometimes you cannot spot the error. Now tell me, where is the error? Third part, what is wrong with this? What is the spelling of their? Here it should be a possessive pronoun. What is there? Please write possessive pronoun. But used as, it becomes an adjective in the usage. Possessive pronoun, brackets write, possessive adjective. Whose names? Their names. How many of you have got this one correct? Still I see a lot of students, but these are rather easy. Shall I move on to the next one? We were aware that she had received many awards and was felicitated on account for her wisdom. This question is based on usage, not based on grammar knowledge, usage point of view. So where is the error? Fourth part, what is it? On account of, for is not correct. Change it. On account of her wisdom. Write the word wisdom. Wisdom, which part of speech is it? Noun, please write. What is the adjective form? Wise. What is the adverb form? Wisely. Wise is different. Knowledge, if someone has a lot of knowledge, that is different. Imagine someone has a lot of knowledge, what do you call that person? Write the word intellectual. Underline the word intellect. Intellect means knowledge. Intellectual, a person with knowledge, a knowledgeable person. Hope you guys are with me. Almost half an hour, 45 minutes over. Slowly the disconnection. Now please write. Some people have a lot of knowledge. They read a lot. They acquire a lot of knowledge. Some nice words are there I want you to learn. First you write the word scholars. Scholar has got two different meanings. A person who does research, what do you call that person? A research scholar. That is different. Here scholar means what? A learned person. A person with knowledge. Another word for that, this is an important word, please write. Polymath. Polymath means a scholar, a learned person, a person with a lot of knowledge. Then you write one idiomatic expression. A person who has a lot of knowledge, we use the expression walking encyclopedia. Walking encyclopedia. Now we are using PEDIA. But traditional PAEDIA. Encyclopedia, what does it have? Knowledge related to any topic. A to Z, any topic, you have to refer a typical encyclopedia. And someone has a lot of knowledge. What do you call that person? He is a walking encyclopedia. A very good expression. Shall we move on to the next one? What is the question number 14? Despite of their best efforts, I expect response from you immediately. Where is the error? First part. Generally what happens in the exam, you have to reach a stage where when you read a sentence, now you, let us say you have read a sentence like this, despite of, don't read the remaining sentence, save your time. You know for sure, despite of, not the right combination. Then you know there is an error in the first part. Mark that and move to the next question. Don't read the sentence, why should you read? Save a few seconds, like that every question you save a few seconds, you may finally get about 1 minute or 1.5 minutes. That makes all the difference. So do you want me to read the remaining part of the sentence? No. So despite of, after despite you should not use of. Which part of speech is it? Why no response? Please remember, nowadays I have been telling this, learning parts of speech one level, level one. A lot of candidates across the country, they are good at level one. Level two is required. What is level two? When you see a particular word in a particular sentence, without any hesitation, you should be able to tell the part of speech of that particular word. Then you are ready for the exam. Now what part of speech is it? Already you have learned. Why no response? Despite, please write preposition. What is it? Preposition. Contrasting prepositions. We talk about two. One is despite. What is the other one? In spite of. How do you write in spite of? Is this right? Is this right? Please remember, in spite of, three separate words. It's a common error. A lot of educated Indians write two words, in spite of one word, of one word. It is not correct. That, shall I continue? Thank you very much. Now, what is the question number 15? Being a good swimmer, there should have been a comma, not full stop. Being a good swimmer, he could keep himself floating in the surface or on the surface? On the surface of the lake. Now this question is related to what? Swimming. Now write a few related words. First you write the word drown. When you don't know how to swim, you read the best book, How to Swim, you jump into the pool. What will happen? You will get drowned. Because we have two types of skills. One, active skills, the other, passive skills. Broadly, skills are classified into two groups, active skills, passive skills. If you take the language skills, speaking and writing, they come under active skills. Reading and listening come under passive skills. Swimming is an active skill. Any active skill, you have to practice. By reading a book, you cannot get it. By listening to someone, you cannot get it. Imagine you read the best book, How to Drive a Car. Then you take your car, what will happen? You will knock off 10 or 15 guys. Very simple. So here, write the word drown. That means to go down. Also write two words. When you enter the swimming pool, one side it is only 4 feet. Then what do you call it? Shallow waters. The other side it is 16 feet. What do you call it? Deep waters. Shallow, deep. In this context, I would like to give one popular saying. Please write, have you copied those two words? Still waters run deep. Have you heard of this any time? Still waters run deep. Still means what? No movement at all. Still waters run deep. When the water doesn't move still, it means that the depth is more. In a way, what it means, those who have a lot of knowledge, they are quiet, down to earth. And there's one more saying, what is it? You all must be knowing. Empty vessels make more noise, the opposite. So still waters run deep. Those with a lot of knowledge, they are quiet, sober, down to earth, and modest. So remember that one. Now shall I move on to the next question? So what is the answer here? And this question is related to what? Previous one, preposition related. And this also on, preposition related. 13, related to what? Again, preposition, on account of. 12, related to what? Possessive pronoun, but used as possessive adjective. And the first one is related to what? A verb form, past tense. Who has got all the 5 correct? Errors. I expected more students. Why? It will take some time. So, frankly speaking, how many of you have read the passage? Please raise your hands. Honest. All of you have read. Oh, this is amazing. Incredible. Unbelievable. Usually I don't see those many hands. So new year, new batch, a new response. That's really good. Please remember, I cannot do that, but once I thought, I was joking. We'll tell the coordinators, ask the students, have you read the passage? The student says, yes, allow, otherwise don't allow. Then how do we know? They may lie. Then we will install a lie detector. But remember, if you don't read the passage, what will happen? And you'll be surprised to know, according to one survey conducted in 2014, in the actual exam, in the actual bank exams, 80% don't read the passage, it seems. 80% don't read the passage. What is the reason? Negative attitude. They think it takes a lot of time. Though we read, we may not answer all the questions and we may not understand. Why to waste time? We'll spend all the time on objective type questions. When you attempt 20 questions, obviously you get a single digit. Today, what is the regular cutoff? Regular cutoff is what? 6 or 7. And 2017, IBPS or RRBPO, the cutoff was, I don't know what to say, 1.75. It's beyond my comprehension. You go to some master, you go to some institute, you attend the mock test for 6 months, and you read all the guides available in the market, and the cutoff is 1.75. How is it? It's a shame for the country. You agree or you don't agree? How can you get, and a lot of students got that particular year, 2017, zero. How can you get zero? It's beyond my comprehension. After taking coaching, you get zero. What is the meaning of taking coaching? So that should not happen. Why does it happen? I will tell you the reason. It happens because many of these candidates don't touch the passage. They don't read the passage. And if they don't read the passage while taking the mock test, it means what? They are not good at reading comprehension skill. They are not good at vocabulary. Grammar, how many questions out of 30? Only 5. Reading comprehension skill and vocabulary, how many questions? 25. So which is more important? Common sense. People don't use common sense. That is a problem. That's why there is a saying in English. What is it? Someone asked, what is common sense? The most uncommon thing in the world is common sense. That is unfortunate, very unfortunate, whatever it is. The passage all about rainforests, what is happening, and the extinction of species, endangered species, logging industry, and bad elements of the society, exploiting the tribal people. The context is that, we'll see the questions. Shall I read out question number 16? Which of the following can be the most appropriate title of the given passage? Do remember, generally when you read the passage, it is inevitable to get the answer. It happens easy, but sometimes a little tricky. You cannot get the title. Then always depend on the introduction and the conclusion. You can guess the title. Now, what is the answer? Option number, second option, what is it? The passage is all about what? Destruction of rainforest. Where do you find rainforest? Now, again, I would like to spend a few minutes. When you read the passage, you stop here, then you are not thinking or acting like an intellectual. Today we talk about environment, we talk about rainforest, we talk about destruction of species. Then you have to, after the session or whenever you are free, you have to learn something about rainforest. That is a question. Where do we have rainforests in the world? Tell me. Which continent? Already they have mentioned one continent in the passage. Amazon forest, where is it? Latin American continent. North American continent, South American. South American, the other word is Latin American. Amazon forest, between the countries Brazil, Peru, all these countries, we have Amazon. There we come across a rainforest. And you come across very rich flora and fauna, plants and animals. Then in Africa we have rainforest. In India also we have rainforest. Where do we have? Western Ghats. You know Western Ghats. Kerala, we have Maharashtra and Kerala, we have a rainforest. So at least some awareness is important. Now, answer is the second option. Question number 17, same in meaning, what is the word? Inhabit, we'll see how it has been used. All of you please go to the second paragraph, you can see the word. What is the sentence here? The rainforest is full of diversity. When it comes to the plants and animals that inhabit it, what do you understand? The plants and animals live there. That's what it means. Similar in meaning, is the word practice correct? Underline the word practice. Which part of speech is this? Immediate answer. It is a noun. Please make a note. And what is the spelling as a verb? S-E. That you should recollect. Cohabit. Here there is nothing like cohabit. Not correct. Survive. Yes or no? No. Dwell in. Please make a note. Answer is the fourth option. Dwell. Dwell means to live as a verb. But write the noun form. Please write dwelling. Generally we use in the plural form. Dwellings. The place where people live. Places. Houses, all those. Dwell here, it is a verb. But now this word has become outdated. Please write outdated. The word dwellings has become outdated. So, answer is the fourth option. What is the fifth option here? Strive. Right? It's an important word. Write the meaning of that. Strive means to try for something seriously. To try for something seriously, with a lot of dedication, with a lot of dedication. Shall I read the next one? Which of the following is most opposite in meaning? And what is the word here? Disappearing. What is disappearing from the rainforests of the world are disappearing. So, simple word, everyday English. But do remember, because it is an easy word, it doesn't mean that you can select one of the options based on your knowledge. Based on the context, you have to. Context, what does it mean? They are vanishing. Disappear, vanish. Now, what is the answer? Arriving? No. Approaching? No. Growing? Yes. Encountering? No. Discovering? Not relevant. So, what is the answer here? Growing. But generally, disappear, what is opposite? Appear. So context is important. 19, opposite in meaning. What is the word? Remote. What is the meaning of the word remote? Isolated. Write the word isolated. Remote village means what? Isolated. Isolated village. Remote village. Short. Is it relevant here? Outskirts. Please write the meaning. Imagine this is a city. The boundary that we call outskirts of the city, means outside the boundary of the city. Have you written? Outskirts means what? The boundary, outside the city. But write one word, please write the word suburb. Suburb, also write satellite town, also write the word commute, commuter. Now generally what happens, a city, the heart of the city, then the outskirts of the city, and when the city gets, it grows a lot, it becomes highly congested, then what happens, in and around the city, some small towns, they start developing. These towns are known as suburbs or satellite towns. Both mean the same, suburb or satellite town. Then what happens, people reside in the suburb or the satellite town for work. Every day they go to the heart of the city. That traveling long distance for work every day is called what? Commute. And the person is called what? Commuter. All are related words. Hope you guys are writing. Now what is the question number? 20. Same in meaning, deterring. Deter. Deter means to stop, to prevent. In the context also the same thing, thus deterring the greenhouse effect. Now intimidating, write the meaning of the word intimidate. Intimidate means what? Frighten, frighten. And write a few combinations, intimidate with knowledge, knowledge. Then you write money. Okay. All of you listen, from tomorrow the paper, mock test paper, will be given to those students who take the mock test. Others, they will not get the mock test paper. Do you understand? If you take the mock test, online test, then when you come here, you'll be given the hard copy. You don't take the online mock test, then here the paper will not be given. I hope the message is clear. And check the notice board also, which exam, the number, and based on that you can decide. Okay? Right. So intimidate, write the combinations. You intimidate others with your knowledge. Knowledge, money, style, confidence, all these. English. When someone speaks very good English, others get intimidated. That is a problem. Now shall I read the next one? What is the question number? So what is the answer here? Preventing. Second option is the answer. Protecting is not correct. Releasing, not correct. Altering, not correct. Answer. Deter means what? Prevent. Write a few words. Prevent. Already have got the word hamper. Hamper means what? Prevent or block. But write one more word. Please write the word impediment. Impediment means hurdle. That also blocks. Hurdle, block, impediment. All these are important words, bank exams point of view. Impediment, hurdle, hamper. You get quite often. And one more thing I would like to suggest, because you're going to come for 2 or 3 months. Please maintain separate notebooks. After the session, you enter the words, create some themes, and enter the words based on the themes. That will help you in the long run. Don't try to remember words in a zigzag manner. Environment, enter all the related words. Then economy, enter the related words. That will help you in the long run. Easy to remember, easy to recollect. Recollection is very important. Imagine today you learn, in the exam you cannot recollect. Does it serve any purpose? It doesn't serve any purpose. Now shall I read the next one? Which of the following is most opposite in meaning? What is the word? Indigenous. It talks about indigenous people or species. What is the context? Indigenous tribes. Already I have given the words. Indigenous means what? Please write this expression. Original inhabitants. Original inhabitants. Also write the word aboriginals. Aboriginals or native people. This is an important word, aboriginals. Have you written? Indigenous means what? Opposite or similar? Opposite. Indigenous, native or local. Opposite is what? Foreign. So what is the answer here? First option. But we'll check other options. Strange. Strange, not normal. A little abnormal. Write one word. Please write the word weird. Americans use this word quite often. They don't say strange. For that, they say weird. Both mean the same. Educated, unnatural, distant. But what is the answer? Foreign. Clear. What is the context? See how the meaning changes. Generally clear, same meaning. What do you think? You think of the primary meaning. Clear something. Remove something that is blocking or something that is hiding, whatever it is. But in this context, what is the meaning? Clear what? Clear rainforest. Neat? No. Pure? Smooth? Tidy? Tidy means what? Write the meaning. Neat. Tidy means neat and clean. Neat and clean. Tidy. What is opposite? Untidy. Also, we use the word mess. Something is in a mess. Mess has many meanings. All the youngsters, where do you have your food? You go to a mess. That is different. Here, mess means what? Not tidy. Another meaning, mess means to trouble someone. If you see English movies, quite often they say, don't mess up with me. If you mess up with me, I'll mess up with you. Very simple. Now, what is the answer here? The fifth option is what? Cut. There's one verb. Please write the verb. This, what is the past form? What is the past participle? Which type of verb is it? Regular or irregular? We have a separate verb. Please put a star mark. Fell, felled, fell. It is a regular verb. And what is the meaning of that? Fell means to cut. Cut what? Bracket, right? Trees. In one exam, they gave a question related to this. Have you written? Yes? They gave a sentence like, they fell many trees in the colony yesterday. Now when you see the time phrase, yesterday, past, you see the verb fell, you think the sentence is right, because you are under pressure. But is the sentence right or wrong? What is the correct expression? They felled, you have to use the past form, they felled many trees. Means what? They cut many trees. Now we'll move on. Is that the last one? Now we have some more. Is it 23? How has ranching resulted in the destruction of the rainforest? Now all of you please go to 1, 2, 3, 4, the fifth paragraph. Please go to fifth paragraph. Here, remember passage, one of the techniques to save your time. You should always read the question, underline the key words. What are the key words here? Underline the word ranching, underline the word destruction. So fifth paragraph, the first sentence, ranching also causes destruction of the rainforests. Ranchers clear large areas of rainforest to make pastures for their cattle. Now what? Which option says that? Third option, what does it say? by clearing large areas of the rainforest in order to make pastures for the cattle. Very simple. Answer is the third option. Number 24, which of the following is not true? Answer is all are true, the fifth option. But we'll see where you find all these options. What is the first option? I want you to be attentive. We have only 5 minutes exactly. By the middle of this century, the population will reach around 10 billion. So all of you please go to third paragraph. What does it say? 10 billion clearly mentioned by 2050. That is true. Many international companies have viewed the governments of the countries having the rainforest in such a way that their economies depend on them now. Please go to the last paragraph. It is mentioned very clearly, the third or fourth sentence. Then the third option, the total percentage of rainforests which once existed on Earth has now reduced to less than half. Where do you find that? The first paragraph. Please go to the first paragraph. From 14%, it has come to 6%. That means it goes with the option. Okay. Now, what is the last option? The destruction of rainforest leads to flooding across the globe. The third paragraph, and you see the same expression. That means what? All are true. But my advice, whenever you come across questions like these, try to avoid. What is the reason? You need to spend a lot of time. You have to go through the passage and search where the options are. That is not advisable. You should take these questions to the end, the fag end of the session. You still have time, answer these questions, otherwise avoid. What is the last question? Why has there been a concern over the destruction of rainforests? So what is the answer? To save time, I'm giving the answer, the third option, only B and D. What is B? An increase in temperature throughout the world has led to many environmental problems, right? Excuse me. What is D? Many exotic, please underline the word exotic. Many exotic species of plants and animals are found in the rainforest only and nowhere else. Write the meaning of exotic. Exotic means rare, very rare. Rare and also write unusual, not usual. The last five questions, shall I read out? The last 150-year period has seen an, underline the indefinite article an, but all the words begin with a vowel letter or a vowel sound. So based on the usage or exposure to the language. Admirable growth, perhaps. Avoidable, you have to choose a positive word based on the context. Mark avoidable wrong. Inexplicable, write the meaning of inexplicable. Difficult to explain. Difficult to explain. Cannot be explained. Irrational, not rational. And what is the last one? Unprecedented. Unprecedented means never seen before, not seen before. Now you have to decide between admirable growth, unprecedented growth. If you read a lot, you will definitely go for the fifth option. So what is the answer here? Unprecedented growth. It's a typical combination. Shall I move on to the next one? What is 27? So unprecedented growth in human population, rapid changes in human lifestyles, and consumption patterns and growth of technologies that has what? Escaped an unlimited exploitation. No. Forbidden. Forbid means prohibit. Write the meaning of forbidden. Prohibit. Predicted. Predict means what? To think of the future, to tell about the future. Predict. Not correct. Visualized. That doesn't go with this context. What is the fourth option? The growth of technologies that has facilitated an unlimited exploitation of natural resources. What is the answer here? The fourth option is the answer. As more and more people demanded and wanted more and more goods and resources, and also acquired the, this is a bit difficult to extract, but underline the expression, to extract these from nature, the natural environment began to degrade. Here you may get tempted to choose license or permission. First, at the outset, you get tempted to choose one of the two, either license or permission. Please strike off the word patience, not relevant here. Pretext, underline the word pretext to write the meaning. Pretext means excuse, excuse. Now here you have to decide capacity, acquired what? Capacity to extract, license to extract, permission to extract. License, permission, one and the same. So you cannot select one of them. But here it talks more about the ability. Capacity is not the right word. They should have used the word ability. But both mean the same. Based on that, what is the answer? The first option, capacity to extract these. How many of you have chosen the first option? Raise your hands. That's very good. I appreciate those students. 29. The process of extraction of natural resources and their conversion into goods for human use also produced byproducts that polluted the environment. Now underline the word polluted the environment. That is positive or negative? Then you have to select a positive word or a negative word. Negative word. Surprisingly, neutral. Accordingly, neutral. Unexpectedly, could be positive, could be negative, neutral. Innocently, not relevant in this context. What is the fifth one? Unfortunately. Unfortunately, the process has resulted in more pollution. What is the last word? This started the second cycle of environmental degradation. Underline the word degradation, deterioration. Finally, as these objects became visible, obsolete, negligible, useless, extreme, or lived out their lives, they were discarded. Now, visible can you use? Mark it wrong. Negligible? No. Extreme? No. You have to decide between obsolete, useless. Both mean the same. Obsolete means what? No longer in use. But between the two, please write the meaning of the word obsolete. Obsolete means no longer in use. No longer in use. And useless, which is a better word, which goes with effective English. Obsolete, you have to prefer that word. So what is the answer here? Second option is the answer. Now the $1 million question. Who has got 25 plus? Please raise your hands. Who has...